So the people that follow me know that about a week ago, I was stranded in the Dominican Republic. I've told this story about 20 times now since I've been back, and I'm gonna try and give y'all the shortened version of it because I don't wanna be out here talking all day. But it was a crazy experience, man. It started off with my boys, Trejo, Oscar, and Brian inviting me out there to see their hometown. We had been talking about this trip for years, and it was finally a reality, man. Oscar called me up about a week and a half ago and was like, look, bro, we got Trejo on the plane. We're on the way. Book your flight. Come out here. So I'm like, bet. I booked my flight for the next day. It was scheduled to leave around like 12 p.m. in the afternoon. I got to the airport that day, ended up boarding the plane. First class was full, of course, but as I was walking back, I was like, damn, this plane is completely empty. And I'm walking down the aisle towards my seat, and I notice this Dominican dude. We make eye contact, and I'm like, you know, what's up? I ain't say it, but I was, you know, we made eye contact, and then I sat down or whatever. So after we took off, the flight attendants actually made an announcement and told us that everybody in business class needed to move to the rear of the plane because there was a weight problem. There wasn't enough people on the plane and all the bags were towards the front. So when we were taking off, that was going to cause an imbalance. So they told us move to the rear. After we get to a certain altitude, then you can go back to your seat. About 20 minutes after takeoff, they turned off the fasten seatbelt sign, and then the flight attendant made another announcement like, okay, you can return back to your original seats. I went back to the exit row, put on my headphones, and I'm chilling for about 10 minutes. And out of nowhere, like, I hear screams. So automatically, I'm thinking, bro, there's either a terrorist on this plane, we about to go down. I'm finna calmly take off my headphones, and I kind of peep back in between the seat like, what's going on, right? So when I'm thinking to myself, whoever this person is, as soon as they walk past this row, I'm about to show them football Americano. They finna catch his head stick. Not today. About two rows behind me, that same dude that I made eye contact with was shaking uncontrollably, and his eyes were rolled back in his head. And there was this young Dominican girl standing right next to him, like, he's having a seizure. So the flight attendants are running towards us. The flight attendant coming from the rear was like, we need to get this plane on the ground now. And she ran up to the front and made an announcement over the intercom, just asking if there was a doctor on board. We're having an emergency. And if you can, please come back and give assistance in the rear of the plane. And so I turned back around and looked at the guy, and he had stopped shaking at that point, and he was sitting in his seat, and his eyes were just rolled back in his head like this. So in my head, I'm like, damn, I hope he's not dead. Straight like that. Like, I've never witnessed a seizure before. It was something that was completely new to me. Eventually, there was a lady that hopped up from first class, and she was like, I'm a doctor, and she came running back to the back. And eventually, she turned the guy on his side. She was trying to talk to him. He wasn't responding. And the flight attendants actually ended up getting him some water, and he was sustained after that. So about 30 minutes later, we ended up landing in Corpus Christi. We had to make an emergency landing, and the medical crew came on board the plane. They put him in a wheelchair, and they took him out, and then we headed to the Dominican Republic. After we took off again, the flight attendants kept coming up to me like, do you want something to drink, a beer or something? I'm like, nah, like, just give me a water. I'm good. Like, I'm just trying to stay hydrated. I don't want nothing to happen to me, because they were saying that the guy actually never had a history of seizures. He never had any medical issues. It was just something that happened at that moment. So I'm freaked out. I'm like, I'm good. I don't want no drinks. I don't want to be sedated. Like, I want to know what's going on this plane, because that tripped me out. I ain't never had nothing happen like that before. So finally landing in DR, I'm having problems with my phone and connecting to the Wi-Fi in the airport. And eventually I got in touch with Trejo. I FaceTimed. It was full. Picked up the phone with a cowboy hat on. I was like, what's up, TJ? I'm like, bro, I'm at the airport. Like, can y'all come get me? I've been trying to get in touch with y'all for 30 minutes. He was like, oh shit, we didn't even know if you was still coming. I'm like, yeah, bro, I'll explain the whole story to you when I see you. And so, yeah, they ended up picking me up. We went back to the resort in Punta Cana. And I didn't even know at the time that their cousin was getting married. So we pulled up to the resort where his cousin was getting married.
That's how you feeling? Yeah.
Let her know what's up.
These fly guys, I feel like I'm underdressed.
And Oscar basically told me, like, look, there's a list. I'm gonna go check and see if it's cool if you at least come in. Just chill here, we got you. Like, the drinks are unlimited. We're gonna bring them out to you. Whatever you want, just ask. So I was like, cool, I'm chilling by the pool, whatever. And then eventually, Trejo was like, TJ, just come in. So I was like, cool. I went in, sat at the table with him, and I was introduced to everybody that was sitting there, which was family. And then after a while, like, they put on some Usher and shit, the whole dynamic just changed. Everybody headed to the dance floor. We all went out there and people just started turning up. Like I said, it was unlimited drinks. I actually ended up dancing with Trejo and them's grandma because I thought she was some random lady standing in the corner. She was older. So I was like, you know, let me see if she wanna dance. It don't look like she having a good time. She was just sitting there observing. So
after that, Trejo was like, bro, you just danced with my grandma.
It was one of the livest weddings I had ever been to. And for the people that were there,
shit, they know.
To Mitch's, which is a mountain about an hour away from Punta Cana. That was pretty cool to see. It took us like 15 minutes to even drive up the mountain.
Woo! What up, homie? What you doing? You just cooling, huh? Enjoying this breeze? Yeah? Oh shit, you not fucking with me? Looked like you was about to step away.
So once we finally got to the top of the mountain, we chilled up there for about 30 minutes. If you ever go to Punta Cana, that's definitely a place you should check out. I'll write the name in the video because I don't know if I pronounced it right, but the views were breathtaking, man. It was something to see.
Hey, you look like Colin, low-key.
And that's the type of shit I live for. I love pretty views. So on the way back to the hotel, we were actually on the highway and we saw this young kid who was like 6 years old, bareback on a cow. He was guiding like a group of 20 cows on the shoulder on the highway. And Trejo was like, TJ, you see that shit? Yo. So boom, we make it back to the hotel in Punta Cana. The rest of the day, we kicked it by the pool, went to the beach. Trejo got his ass in the hot tub, and we were just chopping it up, having a good time, man.